We read in the parsha of Mattos, begins with the laws of Nedarim, the laws of vows and oaths, and the prohibition of violating one's vow or oath. One's not permitted to desecrate his word if he had made a neder or a shua. And the Torah speaks about the ability to nullify the vow or the oath, whether it's the Bezdin, the rabbinic court, or the panel, the equivalent of that, the panel of three ordinary Jews, or the sage who was ordained with the ordination of Moshe Rabbeinu. Even as an individual, he can annul the vow or the oath, or a father annulling the vow of his daughter who hasn't fully left his domain, meaning she's less than 12 and a half years old, although she reaches puberty at the age of 12, and a husband annulling the vow of a wife. These are the laws. We read about Miriam speaking about Moshe Rabbeinu. Moshe Rabbeinu separated from his wife, and Miriam took personal offense to this. She said, she shared that this with Aaron, her brother. We ourselves are also prophets. We didn't separate from our spouses. Why did Moshe separate? Immediately they were summoned to the Ohel Moed by HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and he says, how did you speak about Abdi Moshe? My servant, even if he's only my servant Moshe, and if he's Moshe alone, how do you speak about him? And coupled, he's Abdi Moshe, he's my servant Moshe, how do you speak about him? Don't you understand the difference between your prophecy and his prophecy? He prophesies both. It's in a way state. Upon him, that boy speaks face to face, only in a way state, or a dimension, a lesser dimension of prophecy. Therefore, not compare yourself to Moshe. And this Miriam named a leper. The Torah refers to the prophecy of Moshe as Pakalariro. He's prophesied with a lens. All the other prophets, as we were, Pakalariro, which is an Aramaic word, Greek word, enemiro. It's not as clear. Moshe Rabbeinu was perceived with absolute clarity, not come through a chat to be in, but rather with direct communication. So, retains ovification, Nidoris and all the which pertains in the value of nullification. Moshe is the close, this which God has zat. So, Rashi is that until I, his prophecy, Hashem, as a prophet, God had said, I forward, oh my. Different Sisicha, the commentator explains, the Moshe was not state. That absolute direct clarity comes similar to the prophet. Sinai 4, prophecy, different dimension, was the weight. It was, Tom was radiating this. Zad was distinct. Out of questions for Valley and Moshe, it's not as those of Nadal. Vows were state, old turns in the wake state. Get to Moshe Adover, which is a different than any other. So seemingly, vows pertain to the mission, is to creation. This is Torah. Esach is Torah. We have 200 positive, negative, all communicate context. Why does the deals, Rabbeinu's different dimension, that it was zero, it was wake state, is the Torah context as an oath, not the other commandments, portion of our sexual relationships. All did God choose Moshe's mention, ship, on full, Avdi of Nadorian oaths, mission, for him, there are not good. Here, that was in, and Moshe Rabbeinu says, oh, it's, Eldvaro, Lo Yachel, Eldvaro. Lord, don't treat it ordinary. So violate both. Keep a chilas Hashem. Words as our oath is considered because Shua, the oath, the Voro, Nato, but as any ordinary, consider your violence. He's mentioning, we say action. Action we try. A one's word, person is sacred. Is a sacred. His, if your word is, you renege the word. You go sacred, then you desecrate. Now, the parent of the speech is the no, this tells us, man was, is it a sin? Or to speak ones, it said, was the realization, it's a verse, it's the article, Ervuria, verb says, it just don't, so Ahem brings life, compromise, him. I think this person, for God, you,